This is Silliman University campus, and right behind me is one of the very few remaining remnants of the early American occupation. Dumaguete's share of foreign influences has become the staple of the city's landscape. And today, we are going to taste these influences in their cuisine. I'm standing here right in front of Tres Bistro, owned by my friend Terry. And she's been taking me around on a culinary adventure, chasing the true flavors of her hometown, Dumaguete City.
Hi, Chef! How are you?
Fine, thank you. Thank you for inviting me.
Yes, how is your trip so far in Dumaguete?
Enjoy it very
you
much.
Must be famished. Let's get down to lunch now.
Tengo hambre, mucho hambre.
Okay, let's have lunch.
Why is it called Tres?
I am a part of three sisters.
Tres Marias.
Tres Marias. My oldest sister is Farah, and then there's Cara, and then there's me, Terry. And I, myself, have also three daughters.
Three daughters?
Yes.
So Tres por Tres.
It's basically my mom's recipes.
Recipes?
Yes. Comfort food for our family.
We would have bacalao.
So,
wow. Yes, so
that's... bacalao a la Vizcaína?
Yes,
is that with con tomate y pimiento, no?
And potatoes.
And potatoes.
Mm. Yeah. We also have the spring chicken. It's spring not chicken. Spanish, but it's our version of the spring chicken. It's 12-day-old homegrown chicken.
Homegrown, really?
Deep fried.
Deep fried.
So we call it here tugnos. It's a small fish sauteed in olive oil and garlic. It's good, huh?
Really good. So let me try the...
It's the shrimp ceviche.
Yes.
Okay. It's with red egg.
In a way, it's like a shrimp quinilao.
It is, yeah.
But the salted egg gives it a different dimension. Parang yung layering of flavors.
Iba,
The saltiness comes from the salted
from
egg.
The red
egg. So you're going to show me this?
Yes. This is Chef Elizar. He's going to demonstrate how it's going
to
be.
Okay, cannot wait.
Yeah.
We have the shrimp, white onion, whole black pepper, and the red egg, and olive oil, and the vinegar, and the salt.
Salt, okay.
We'll put salt in the water. Okay, so while waiting for the water to come to a full boil, we're going to open the red eggs and we're going to mash it.
You know, I mash my salted egg and put it in my dressing.
Pour some olive oil.
Some olive oil.
Over the red egg.
Wow.
We put in the white onions. And freshly ground black pepper.
And then put the vinegar.
The white cane vinegar.
Wow.
Mix it well.
And you can say, truthfully, this is your mother's concoction?
Yes, it is. We will now blanch the shrimps. Just like a few seconds.
Yeah,
just
so you want them half-cooked.
Half-cooked, yes.
So in Filipino, we call
malasado. And then after we blanch it, we're gonna put it in an ice bath, right? So as you can see, the shrimps is very plump and nice color. It's pink. And then that's when we mix the shrimps in our red egg. So we garnish it with some parsley.
Oh, so the garlic bread, the crostini. Garlic. The proof of the ceviche is in the tasting. Let's see. More of the salted egg, the salted, the red quinoa. There. Looks pretty enough. Look at this.
How is it?
Nice.
Yeah, perfect with ice cold beers.